Also, hello guys. Today, as I announced on the stream, we bought an i7-4790. You are going to ask yourself why I bought an i7 and not an i5 and a better video card. Well, I need the rendering to be way faster, and I might do more heavy streaming than before. So the i7 would be the best choice for me, since I will keep the GTX 750 Ti and the 8 GB of RAM. So just remember this, I say it right now, we won't stop doing i3 testing. The i3 will still be here.
We will be keeping the i3 processor.
So. Yeah. And the other thing I can do with the i7 4790, I could disable hyper-threading, so it will be kind of an i5. So I could do tests like if it was an i5.
An i3, an i5 and an i7.
Yeah, I mean, if I disable hyper-threading and I keep it like that, it will be an i5. And if I disable two cores, it will be an i3. So, but I will do some testing to see if it's the same as having an i3. So if I do that, I will just let you know in a video or something like that. So we have the i7, 4790, not the K, just the 4790 standard edition. And we also bought a CPU cooler, a ThermalTake Frio Silent 1.4. It's a 140 millimeter fan.
It's really big.
Yeah.
You will see that.
That's all the announcements I got to do, so we're now going to put it in my PC.
Thank you.
Okay, so now we're going to start changing the stuff here. We're just removing the video card, so it's easier to put the aftermarket cooler there. We still have the i3 here, then the RAM here, and the GTX 750 Ti, and here's the power supply, just for you to know. Maybe you already know this, but it's never a bad thing to go back to the basics. I also have the HDD here, and a solid state drive that I use for the OS and for some games like Battlefield 4, but the rest of the games I test on the channel are on the HDD. It's a SATA 2-400 RPM drive. It's pretty slow, that's why I have the SSD, and we're going to remove the GTX 750 Ti. So if I can reach this. And here it is. Yeah, it has some dust here. I haven't cleaned it yet for like 6 months or something like that. So, well, it's here. We're going to
put it somewhere safe.
Yeah, I don't know where.
I would think maybe here.
Okay, away from this magnet.
Yes.
We put it right here.
That's it.
Okay, there's the card. And now we're going to remove the i3. So we're going to we can do it with our hands. So first, as you can see here, we have to put this out. It's plugging the fan to another one, so it gets enough power to turn on. We just spin this to the right and we get it up.
Yeah.
And that's it. And you carefully try to remove it so you make sure that these are correctly moved. And it's pretty strong thing here. Okay, there you are. Yeah, it wasn't very careful. As you can see here, it's the old thermal paste. And on the i3, we can also see the old thermal paste. We are going to remove it with some paper.
Here's some advice. If you want to certainly remove the stock cooler and clean the PC and stuff, you should buy thermal paste before, because if not, I mean, it won't work as before. So
yeah,
keep that in mind.
The thermal paste we're using is Arctic Silver 5, so we're going to remove the thermal paste. Okay, so as you could see right now, we removed the thermal paste on the CPU. That's the i3-4150, and here is the stock cooler. As you can see, we removed the thermal paste too. Okay, now, as you can see here, we just move this tab like this and move it up, and there's the CPU again. So now we're going to pick it up. I cannot. Okay, so just be careful because there's some pins in the socket, I mean in the motherboard, and they are very easy to break. So you can see there are no pins here like in the motherboard, and the motherboard has its own pins. Now we're going to put it right here, where in the box where it came. Well, I cannot put it okay here.
It was the other way around.
Okay, it's here. It's not going anywhere because I might use it again. We put it back into its own box. I will open the box later. So here is the box of the i3. It's the same box as the i7, but
a little bit more.
Yeah, I mean, here's the i7, as you can see here. That's the CPU we're going to put now into the case. So, okay, so we're going to, before putting the CPU, we're going to put the aftermarket cooler, since some of the brackets need to be put behind the motherboard. So we're going to remove the motherboard from the case. So what we're going to do first is unplug the SATA cables. There is some kind of tab here that you press and you remove them, just like Legos. And
it's so easy.
Yeah, remove the SATA cables. Then the 24-pin cable, we're going to remove it too. Removed. We're also going to unplug this 4-pin cable. And okay, we have to also remove the frontal USB, the USBs, and we're not going to unplug the power buttons since it's a long cable and it's kind of a mess to put it back. And we're going to unscrew it from the case. So we have removed the motherboard from the case. So now we are going to put this behind the motherboard, because it's where it mounts the aftermarket cooler. It's going to hang to this. So this is the heatsink itself. As you can see, it's a huge heatsink, but it will fit in the case, as you can see right here. So this is the heatsink, and now I'm going to show you the fan. As you can remember, I said it's a 140mm fan, as you can see right here. So, that's pretty much it. So now we're going to place... So here's the back of the motherboard. As you can see, the foamy part of this bracket has to go behind. And as you align it with the four holes behind the motherboard, you have to pick up these screws and put one on each side. So we're going to put them there first, and after you do that, we're going to use these ones on the other side to kind of put it fixed there so it won't move. So hang on, just going to put them there so you can see the four screws. For me, part is kind of hard to go through. I mean, while you're being recorded. If you're doing it alone, it will be way easier. Okay, so after we do this, I will do it easier than this. You pick it up and you do this, this, ah, there you are. Try to align it with all the holes so you don't have any problems. Here's a line, here it isn't. Almost there. Okay, fantastic. As you can see, it is right there. I'm going to pick these ones up. You gotta be careful here. As you can see now, the screws are easy to see on the other side. And the foamy part always has to go to the motherboard, so we don't have any problems. This is meant to be done by hand, so we're doing it correctly, as you can see. Last one. Ah, there it is. We place the backplate behind the motherboard, and as you can see, it's correctly placed there. The foamy part goes to the motherboard, and the non-foamy part, I mean the metal, goes away from the motherboard.
All right, so now we're going to put this bracket over here, just like that, trying to align the, you know, the nuts with the part you are going to screw.
So now we take these screws,
and one by one, try to screw them.
Literally screw them.
Yeah. Don't screw them.
Yeah.
All at a time.
I mean, first you want to screw the ones on the opposite sides, so the bracket doesn't move like just happened. I mean, it won't damage anything, but it's cleaner to do that. As you can see now, it won't move. It's still there.
So you're going that going for you. Which is nice. And if it moves a little, I mean, you will be able to, you know, overcome that situation by trying them out. Alright, there it is. So that's it.
Well, now we're going to do the next step. So we're now going to put in the CPU, i7-4790, as you can see there. So you carefully try to put it right over the CPU socket. As you can see there, it fit. As you can see here, these both these plastic parts are aligned with the CPU, so we didn't place it incorrectly. So now just move this tab down, and some force, maybe hang on a minute, like that. So force will be needed to be applied. Yeah, that sounds terrible, but you're doing it right. Trust me. And there it is. We place the CPU. And now we're going to put some thermal paste over it. As you can see right here, the heatsink, the aftermarket cooler, has some thermal paste from Thermaltake. This is Thermaltake didn't pay me to do this, so thermal take.
Yay!
So, well, now we're going to put some So we have the i7 placed there into the motherboard, and we're going to put some thermal paste on it.
It's from Thermaltake, as I said just a second ago. I think that's enough. And that's it.
I think I put a little too much. It will be well spread by the heating. So what you have to do is to, as you can see the heating right here, there's going to be a piece of plastic here covering it. You have to remove that first. As you can see, Rodrigo is showing up here. This will be sticking there, and you have to remove it. As you can see, please peel off label before you use it. So after you peel that, you have to pick it up.
You move it right here.
So you put the fan, and with this one, you are going to tie the fan to this side of the heatsink. And that's pretty much it. We are going to put the cable back where they belong, and we're going to turn it on and start doing some baseline. Thanks for watching, and see you next time. And yeah, enjoy the video. Thank you.